is Colin. I started this in spring, actually in winter of this year, January. Originally started because my brother came up and asked me a question. He's 8 years old, and he said, "You're such a cool programmer, I want to be just like you." And so I said, "All right, I'll teach you programming." He, of course, wanted to start out making video games and all that crazy stuff. And I said, "Well, it probably would not be a good idea to start him with something like C++, and I don't want to even get him started with Java." So, in effort to avoid all of that crazy stuff, I was thinking of the perfect programming language to start an 8-year-old off at. And what I came to the conclusion was, there's a lot of options out there, but they're either hard to set up or complex syntax. You have to download things, there's platform problems, you know. So what I tried to do was create a web-based programming language that I call Koala. It's a scripting language that compiles to JavaScript, so it can run on any computer that runs JavaScript, which is basically anything but a toaster. So it should be pretty cool once we get out there. Progress I made last spring, I built an editor that has syntax highlighting and parsing, I started on the compiler. This summer I'm working on a different research project, so I wanted to devote most of my time to that, and so I haven't been working on Koala as much. But I got a few emails at the end of last semester about some students who were interested, Nick and another student, Ezra, who's no longer able to work on the project. But they were both interested in working on Koala. So now we have, I guess, two people working on the Koala project.
So I guess I'll just talk about it. Just
that's not coming up. All right, so Koala is an interpreted scripting language, parsed and executed with JavaScript. I've been mostly working on the website so far this semester, which looks pretty good so far, and I imported your workbench this morning, so the editor, the IDE, it's plugged it into the Rails site this morning, so that looks pretty good. So basically, Koala is a scripting language for learning, and it tries to instill open source values in beginner programmers. So when you go to the site, you're immediately presented with an IDE type editor that you can click like save or run. And when you save a project, it saves as like to the database as like an open source thing that other people can build on top of and program for, extensions and stuff for it. So it instills open source values. Could show some screenshots of it if we can't get the PowerPoint up at all. That's what the homepage looks like right now. And this is the editor, i.e. I had a screenshot of it in the website too. So. So it looks pretty good. Yeah. Any questions?
Because, okay, so there are lots of questions to be asked. So the first question to be asked is, Koala is the last, has been occupying the last place in the project stream. It has never, no blogs have been updated, no code has been put. So why is it the case?
Code has been put. I don't know how do you, the site isn't syncing with Git. It's been pushed. The RCOS site isn't syncing with Git. Is it you have to go through some?
Not
17
hours.
Yet.
It has been updated 17 hours.
Yeah. So it's been updated. It's just not reflecting that on the RCOS site, and there have been 3 or 4 blog posts.
Three or four. So the question is, can you, usually the first presentation we always ask, what is your rough schedule? What is the schedule need? So we have 6 weeks gone, we have 6 more weeks left.
Yeah.
So what are your projected work?
plans.
Yeah.
Well, I want to get syntax highlighting working on the text area, which I'm not sure how to do, because that's been difficult.
That's the project I was working on.
So, oh, did you get that? She had figured out?
It's implemented on a different branch. If you want to pull that, I can show you how.
Cool. Okay, yeah. So syntax highlighting, get the parser plugged into the website, which I know you've been working on also. Yeah, so, and the user system is not completely finished yet. You can't log in yet, but you can register and stuff, so I want to finish that.
So you are working on the front end, right? Was you working on the front end?
Right, this is all the server stuff. I was working on more of the actual scripting language.
Yeah, I was working on the website and the back end in Ruby on Rails.
Okay. The other thing usually people do is, especially at this age, is whenever they write code, they want to display what that code, show off the code and so on. Usually there is a community website where they put the display their code and what the code does in execution.
So it's on Git, you can pull it. If there's Ruby on Rails installed, I mean, I could show a demo of it running. I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What does Koala code look like?
Koala, the syntax, it's really simple. It's explicitly simple. It's like input, output, say, listen, and then a variable name. I haven't seen too much of the syntax because that's what Colin, that's the part that Colin's
so the Colin did the syntax. It's supposed to be simple. This is any, he says his 8-year-old brother could do it and his 80-year-old grandfather could do it. That is the idea, the spread that he wants to. It needs to be, so at least the next talk, it has to be much more polished. Now that not only you are giving a talk, and it is all immortalized. So the videotape, and it has been put in the YouTube and so on, and people all over going to listen. So you want to do something so that everybody will say, we want to hire me next.
Yeah.
So that should be the motivation.
Yeah, I don't know why the PowerPoint didn't say it.
The PowerPoint said that's another thing is usually you should have that all the adapter, or if you do not have an adapter, you should ask others to bring that up.
Yeah.
Okay, you learn.
All right.
Okay. So we had visitors and we thought we'll do a good show, but that's okay. We make mistakes, we learn. That's what we do. Next time we'll not make mistakes.
You probably jinxed him.
I probably jinxed him.
Sorry.
Okay. No, you didn't. Good luck. I hope you do your best.